Okay, so I'm feeling a little bit more better. I'm feeling way better than I have the last couple of days. I don't know what I recorded or not, but so I came to the hospital. I'm in my private room now, but I came to the hospital because I had like a pretty substantial bulge like in my stomach, and I like passed out when I don't know if it's passed out. I just woke up on the floor. So you can deduce what you want with that. Hold on, let me see if I can put you guys here. Okay, let me move these wires. Okay, so you could deduce whatever you want from that. Came to the hospital. They did like a bunch of testing. Honestly, I don't like needles. I don't like being into metal tubes, but it was like the first time I went into like this cylindrical tube. I was in there for like 45 minutes and I could not move. And then I went into one with like a donut and it was like moving back and forth. It's weird. And I got an x-ray, but anyway, so I told you guys that I have a fear, like a year ago, something like that I have a fear that you guys know when I have a kid, and I'm trying to have a kid now. And anyway, I have a fear that they're going to remove like my baby maker. And it's true. So like the one thing that I feared in life is true right now. So like I already cried. I already like I'm just like I think I'm at acceptance, but tomorrow's the actual like surgery. Hopefully tomorrow's the surgery, because they said that like I have two surgeries before, I mean, I have two people doing surgeries before me. So, like if all goes well and their surgeries are smooth, it doesn't take longer, I'll do my surgery in the afternoon. It's like, I feel like life's not fair for me right now, to be honest with you guys, because like I lost my cat, and then a week from the day that I lose my cat, I'm gonna go to surgery to lose my ability to carry or have a child. It's like really hard for me right now, so I'm trying to figure out like what do I do? Like I invested so much money already, and it's all for nothing, and I'm in like debt now because my cat's bills, these bills, and my past bills. I can't win, and I don't understand like this is like the most, I don't know. And then I was like trying to perk myself up, and I'm like, oh, I could just get a surrogate. I don't have surrogate money for someone to carry a child for me. And then I'm trying to be like cool and collected, because when I lost my cat, I was like crying, and when I like posted the video, I was so annoyed with myself. But I don't know. Oh, you guys, this bag has saved my life. I didn't tell anybody, like none of the family, anything like that. It's just, like I told you guys before, that my mom's like, oh, when we're gonna have a kid? And I told her that it's gonna be harder for me to have a kid. And she just feels like I could just sleep with someone and get pregnant, no problem. I mean, she doesn't feel that. I don't get that feeling from her as much as I did before. But to know that like my uterus and both of my ovaries are gonna, most likely both of my ovaries are gonna be removed tomorrow, which means that I'm gonna have to start menopause, soon too. So that's gonna be a fun thing. This is a lot, to be honest. A lot. Like, I'm drained, and I just wanna like go home and see my cat, which my cat's not there, but anyway, so I told my sister. Okay, so to give me something to do while like I am like healing after, I decided to like record a bunch of things, just cause like when I'm like laying in bed and like pain, I can like distract myself with like poorly editing, but editing a video. So today's video is gonna be a hospital room tour. Yay! Yay! So I'm gonna show you guys. Welcome to the crib. All right, so this is the entrance. So walking through here. Next, we have, well, close to the bathroom. This is a random sink here, but this is where my things are. So I just have my shoes, my bag. There's actually a safe here, but I don't have anything valuable that like I need it for, you know. Here is the bathroom. Been utilizing the trash a lot. The bathroom. Okay, so I'm coming out. I like to like crack this door. No, actually, I like to keep the bathroom door open because my bag is there, and like if you keep it open, you can't see the bag. But this is my area here. So where the magic happened. I have a the magic. I have one of these beds that like you can like lift up like this. So you guys, you know, I've been enjoying this tremendously so far, you know. Next, this is where, ooh, gotta cover stuff up, but this is where my IV is. I'm currently unhooked because I don't know if this is graphic, but because I can drink and stuff now. This is like my toiletry area type thing. Actually, I gotta move my wet wipes over here, but I have a towel. This is where my toothbrush and toothpaste is, some extra napkins. I was using these drawers, but then I stopped. This is a chair for when I have guests. I kind of want to move to this section here, to be honest with you guys. But I'm alone. They said I will be alone for the duration of my stay here. I just want to kind of single room, if anything, but I guess I don't get a single room. But like, I kind of want to move to this section here, you know, just for like the window purposes, get that natural lighting when I'm vlogging. But when I first got here to this room, I did have a roommate, but she was leaving today. Well, this morning she left early, and I had to like walk to like a bathroom that's like super far because the bathroom was like leaking, you know. But I kind of want to move to this area. You think they'll let me move to this area? I don't know. Would you guys feel like it? I think I like it better. It's like so much open space, you know, and the windowsill is definitely a selling point. And then also
if I do like want privacy, I can just use these blinds, right, to cover, and then also move this chair over here. When I had lunch, I did have lunch here. My lunch here, it was just natural lighting. It was beautiful.
It boosts my spirits, which is super silly, but like it really did. I just wanna ask if I can move, but I don't wanna be annoying. All right, so back to my section.
All right, so this is my little table. This is my setup. I actually have to move these over. This is how I clean myself. I got my tea going. It's still super hot. I just like actually started it. And I still have some tea left in this tea bag, so I'm gonna hold off on getting using some more, even though I do have a couple more tea bags. But I'm gonna tell you guys the setup, okay? So this cart, usually it's like a little bit closer to me. The first thing I need off the bat soon, more often, is my headphones, my this is like alcohol, and my, you know, lip gloss stuff, and then also face mask. But since I'm alone in here and the doctors doesn't come, well, they actually, I get like every 3 hours someone comes to give me some type of injection or to take blood from me, either or, is like Russian roulette. And but I have the face mask there, that way if when I'm like laying down here I can just grab it. I have tissues. Went through like a bunch of these already, emotional state that I am. Then I have like my face stuff, so my face creams. I have yet to use this yet, but I have been using these. This is where the ice water usually is, but I poured it in here. This is like my condiment snack section. Hopefully everything's in focus. But I have two of these. I have some Sweet and Low, a tea bag, two True Lemons, which I use half of them, one already. These are the Mrs. Dash salt-free seasonings. And I have pepper, and I have some sugar, like sugar at the bottom. And then these are mints. So I'm most definitely gonna like drink as much as I can before 12 a.m. because I don't want that mouth thing. The one thing that I'm kind of annoyed about, in my travel bag, I usually have, like wire headphones just in case like these die and I don't have a charger. Oh, I do have my charger. It's here, by the way, okay, on the bed. I have my jacket here. Yeah, I'm about to like refresh myself with these. I gotta go into the bathroom, but I want to get some more of my face stuff with me. That way when I clean, I could feel like partially human, you know. But I'm also afraid of like putting on like scented stuff like this. I have another lotion that's like non-scented, but it's not going to cover the area, so I just got to be careful with that. Do I not have more lotion? I feel like I should have more lotion though, because like I keep, oh no, they're scented, never mind. I'm sorry, I'm rambling, you guys. Anyway, so I got this, and the guy, he makes sure that they're warm when he gives it to me. So right now, I'm gonna get my face up right now. It's super warm, so I'm about to go take a shower. Oh, like a fake shower. Alrighty, time to set up myself and get close this door. So I have my, okay, so this is my bathing setup here, you know, got the trash behind me so I can just throw things in the trash. Oh, she's looking nice. Okay, so I have the robe on backwards, but I think after I wash, I'm gonna put it on the right side, the right way. By the way, I'm wearing like leggings. Oh, I'm wearing like leggings. There's so much lint on my leggings. There's so many like particles. It's a lot. Okay, so time for me to take this jailhouse bath right now. Oh, it's so warm though. I'm really excited. My nurse, he came through. Okay, shower is complete. I'm not too sure about using this on my face just yet. So before I go to bed, I'm just gonna wash my face like normal. Well, normal with a little soap, disintegrating soap, whatever. This is burning. I have underwear on, but I decided to like wear it the proper way, just to make it easier. Like, I don't know what my emotion's gonna be like tomorrow, but I was in a really dark place. So I just don't know if I'm gonna have like enough energy to like, you know, because like right now I'm feeling good, I'm feeling great, but the sooner
the process of me, sorry, I actually don't even want to speak it. I don't want to speak words, so. It's just like the realest, actually, I don't know if it's like super echoey, but like, it's just a realization that it's official. I could never be a mom. And also the fact that my body is going to change so much because of the menopause, that I won't look the way I look now. I won't feel the way I feel now. I won't have a period, you know? I won't feel like a woman, basically, you know? Like, anyway, gotta stop. Okay, my skincare is complete. I'm looking like an oily, greasy mess, but yeah, I had to stop drinking water at like 12 a.m. It's already 10, so I think I'm gonna stop now just to be on like the safe side. I have an IV in my arm, you guys. It's like slowly getting redder and redder. It is freaking me out. Oh, I should probably cut on the light. Oh no, I'm not gonna cut on the light. I forgot what I was gonna say.